Hey everyone, welcome back. Today, we'll continue our journey in making our smart enemy AI. Our goal in this video is to make the fleeing mechanics for our enemies. This happens when their fear level reaches a certain threshold that will make them flee and run away, emulating that they are trying to prioritize their survival. Just like this. And this. And this too. By the end of this video, we will learn how to collaborate with ChatGPT to make a feature for our game. I'll also be sharing some pros and cons and some tips to keep in mind when using ChatGPT as your assistant in developing your games. First, I asked ChatGPT if it's capable of creating a game. My first attempt was a failure since the ChatGPT network was overloaded, so I tried again, and this is its reply. To save time, I will not be narrating the reply, but instead, I'll be just showing clips of it. Just pause the video if you want to see the entire conversation. Then I asked it to help me make a feature for a game, and it outright rejected me and offered guidance instead. So I discussed how our game currently looks like and asked it to make the fleeing mechanic for our enemies. ChatGPT showed the steps to make the features, but ChatGPT's concept did not meet with our current design, so back and forth I discussed further the features of our game, and from time to time I get problems with network errors and have to generate the response once again. After several entries of asking ChatGPT and letting it understand the current state of the game, I finally decided to just go ahead and give it a function to work on. So I sent it a function that creates fear to the enemy when a teammate nearby dies. ChatGPT clearly understands the function, but not the entirety of the feature that I want. It deducts the fear meter, but deducts it per update, and we only need to deduct it once. So I told it that we need to deduct it only once if a teammate around the enemy AI dies. It then gave a revised version of the function. With a little tweak, the function now works as intended. Although it should be adding fear, not deducting the fear meter. I decided to just skip the issue for now and tackle this some other time. Now that the fear function is set in place, I then proceeded to make the animations and state behaviors for the enemy AI when the fear reaches the flee threshold. Then I asked ChatGPT to make a run away from the player function, and it gave me some random function that is not related to nav meshes, which is the method of navigation that I used for my enemy AI. So I asked it to revise the code and utilize the current nav meshes. It then revised the code, but as I tested it, it resulted in some weird behaviors, so I tweaked it a bit to make it work as intended. Also, the enemy tend to face the wrong direction when it runs to the target destination, so I asked ChatGPT to fix it, and again, it gave me a revised code that is not usable. So, with a lot of love and hate conversations with ChatGPT when it decides to unnecessarily add a feature I didn't ask for, and with a lot of revisions, we finally arrived at a working code and finally made the enemies flee from the player correctly. I did the first phase of the testing and realized that there are some behavior features that are missing from the fleeing mechanic. For example, if the enemy runs to a set destination and encounters the player, just simply walks by, not noticing that the player is nearby. Totally immersion breaking. So I fixed this by making an additional behavior. If it sees that the player is nearby, it will do its best to dodge and evade the player. Another issue is when the enemy is hit at the back, does not do anything, so I added a response to it. Now, the enemy will roll away from the player when hit. Another issue is also when the enemy sees the player. It will just run forward, not cautious about the player's location. So I fixed this by making it look at the player when it sees the player. This will hopefully emulate cautiousness. I did the second phase of the testing and realized that the enemies just run away all the time and do nothing about it, even though you're trying to kill it. So I added a behavior that when you are attacking it, there's a chance that it will do a counter-attack. I also added a behavior that if the enemy is cornered and is attacked, it has no choice but to fight back with a shield bash and a combo. This will hopefully emulate tactics and desperation to survive. In the third testing phase, I realized that chasing the enemy is tedious and annoying, especially if the enemy AI is too good at evading and escaping the player. So I gave some handicap to the player to make it fun and less annoying. First handicap is if the enemy is running fast and if you hit it at the back, it will stumble down, giving you free hits when it recovers. This will make the chasing gameplay more fun and realistic. The second handicap is to avoid the enemy from spamming rolls and dodges. So I tied the stamina stats to it. If the enemy's stamina is low, the rolling behavior will be disabled. The third handicap is if you hit the enemy with low HP, it will be maimed and crippled, lowering its mobility and will be open for an execution, which is our fourth handicap, the crippling execution. When the enemy is crippled, the player can perform an execution with very high damage that mostly will kill the enemy in one blow. Do you like the solution so far? If you do, consider liking the video, or if you want to follow my development journey, feel free to subscribe. Having ChatGPT as an assistant has its pros and cons. It can clearly explain and elaborate how the function or code works, so tracing functions and features will be easier since it can explain to you clearly what that function does. It is knowledgeable in the syntax and documentations of Unity and programming languages. Basically, it's faster than Google in finding solutions for your current problem. But do not trust everything ChatGPT gives you. You still need to review your code. You can communicate with it like a real person. It knows your previous conversations and responds to you based on them. If you're using ChatGPT for free, you will have a lot of network issues. The AI's network is too busy and sometimes you need to regenerate a response, especially if it's a long one. It's best to keep the questions short, or if you are asking to solve a script, send it a function instead of the entire script to reduce its reply context. ChatGPT unnecessarily gives you features you didn't ask for, or it changes your current function randomly without you telling it to. So review all the time and understand what ChatGPT gives you. It'll explain the code clearly, so read all the rundown of the given code all the time. It does not always give you a consistent, optimized version of a solution. For me, it's best to use ChatGPT to solve bits of the problem. Don't give it a huge problem to solve. Just do it one bit at a time. ChatGPT is a great tool, and I'm sure it will improve a lot in the coming years. It will make development easier, giving us developers more time thinking of game mechanics that makes our games more fun and exciting. On the flip side, it could potentially pave the way to a lot of poorly made games that would flood the game industry, since making games is now easier than before. I'm curious about what your thoughts are. Will AI take over our jobs? Will it be a great assistant for us devs? Or will we be a slave to it and be dependent on it? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments. Speaking of comments, people are asking me how I made some features of my game, so see you on the next devlog where I do a step-by-step tutorial on how I made my Dark Souls-like health bars.